Good morning, everyone. We welcome you to this webinar day two. If I'm audible, please let me know in the chat session. I request all the participants, let me know in the chat session if I'm audible. Okay, with this, we'll start with our day. Before we start our day, let me tell you a few facts what we had for yesterday. First of all, I thank you all for attending. And secondly, we had a very common doubt, that is, most of the participants have requested me, some have mailed me also. Regarding certification, sir, I have submitted the feedback, but I didn't get my certificate. So this is a 3 days webinar, which started yesterday and will be followed until tomorrow, that is 26th June. So after the successful completion of all the 3 days and attending all the sessions, completing the quizzes and scoring 50%, only then you'll be getting the certificates. So a note on this, that it's a 3 days webinar and you'll be getting a certificate for sure tomorrow, that is after the webinar has been completed. And secondly, I also got some feedbacks telling that I was a bit fast some moment of time, and if you couldn't cope up with me, that I was in advanced moments in higher topics. So those who couldn't get me or didn't understand the basics, I request you all to watch the previous video, that is the webinar 1, Android development, that is the first webinar, and that will surely help you to understand the concepts much more clear. Am I clear until here? I request all the participants to be active in the chat session so that we have an interactive session. Yes, sure, I'll share you the link of the previous webinar. So with this, we'll see the topics for today. Link of the previous class, so just a minute, I'll share you. Okay, I'll share the previous link class in a moment. Until then, we'll see the agenda for today, what we have. So agenda for today, we'll be learning file components, which you missed yesterday. Among the many sensors what we have, we'll see accelerometer and how it works. Following with that, we'll see location sensor. So we'll try to get the live address of our location and then even the latitude and longitude and so on. Following with that, we'll see social, that is messaging or phone call. How can we do a messaging from direct from the application, or calling the intent, that is the application which we have in our mobile phone from the first, that is messaging app or the mobile phone calling app. We'll see how can we link that thing to there. And then we'll see one more is battery management. So in this battery management, what we'll say is we'll get to know the status of the battery, the charge what we have, the temperature what we have in the phone, and so on. And we'll see like where can we use all these things and how will this help us to go ahead and require this in our projects. And all the things what is being listed here are really very helpful if we see the application and where we can we use this. So this is the agenda for today to be completed. So let us go to our browser and then start doing it. So open the browsers. So MIT App Inventor 2. Click on Create Apps. Choose the desired user ID and a password, that is Google account. Okay, we are on our screen. If you have any doubts regarding anything such, please let me know in the Q&A session and we'll try to answer the same at the same moment. So what we'll do is very first, like yesterday we had created an application that is a doodle app, that is drawing application, and then we had few questions was how can we create it, that is how can we clear the screen was the question yesterday, which has been asked before ending the webinar. So we'll see how can we use that thing. So before that, we'll go and open that application. I think so that was app 9. No, okay, no worries. We'll just create a new application, start a new project. And give this name as a doodle. Or okay, app 10. You need to search MIT App Inventor 2. Sir, how to minimize the screen? I think so. Just double click on the top ribbon, and that should minimize it. Okay, so I created a new application, that is new app, and then I'm changing the very first thing what I do is I change the theme because I really don't like it. Once done, we'll go here and then from the drawing and animation, take up the canvas, drag it here. We'll quickly cover this because we have already done this yesterday. Center, and this also to the center. And then click on the canvas and then change the height to, I'm not sure about the pixel size, so I'll change the height to some consider 80% of the screen and then width to 87% of the screen. Okay, done. Once we are done with this, let us go to the blocks. I think so this is the same thing what we had done yesterday, so I'm going to add some extra features to this. By adding a button and linking it to a call canvas, one clear. That's an awesome tryout at Pradeep Singh. So we'll just show the same thing to everyone. Sir, please post app download link. I'm not getting like exactly what it is, app download link. Can you please make it clear? Click on blocks here. And then canvas. Click on canvas and then choose canvas when dragged. And here, again click on a canvas and then go down. And then you have draw line, call the draw line. And then for the first, what we'll do is previous X, get a previous X, and then also get a previous Y, and then a current X, and then a current Y. So this will let me draw the outline on the screen. So let me check out. So let me share the screen first. We have very interesting things to do today. We'll see, complete it fast. Okay, sorry for the mistake. I have selected current text two times. That is a good checkout. I'll change it. Blocks. Good. This is wrong. So it should be a current Y. Okay. Thank you for correcting me. So I'm on my screen and you can see it can write anything. So now what we'll do is when we shake a phone, this complete should the complete should be cleared. That is, the canvas should be cleared. We'll try to make it a bit smarter type. So what will happen is when we shake a phone, it should completely get cleared. So for that, we'll go to the designer screen back. And now, how will we sense the shaking? Start X and start Y are different than the previous Y and X. Yes, it's completely different. So we need a sensor for detecting that the device has been shaked. So for that, out of many sensors, what we need is, we cannot use barometer, light sensor and all. We can use accelerometer sensor. And when we drag and drop the accelerometer sensor, and now here is the question is, when we drag and drop the accelerometer sensor, you couldn't find the same sensor on the screen UI, but you have that in a component list, but you cannot find that out in the screen UI, because if you see on the bottom of the screen, you can see non-visible component, which means accelerometer will work on the background, not in the foreground, and that will not be shown. So hence, because of that, it is there in a non-visible component. So this is the difference. Like this will not be seen to the user, but that will be present. Okay, so you can see I have accelerometer sensor here. And here you can, on the properties of the accelerometer, it should be enabled. And the minimum interval is 400 milliseconds. Remember, in MIT App Inventor, intervals are intervals, delay, whatever it is, these are in microseconds. So if it is 1000, then it is 1 second. And the sensitivity is to moderate. I'll keep it to moderate as of now, or let me keep it to strong so that I get a more accuracy and more sensation. So once done, I'll go to the block and then click on accelerometer from my right side on the palette. Click on accelerometer, and then if you go up, you have when accelerometer is shaking, that is when the device is shaking. I'll go to the canvas and then call the Clio. You have here one method that is call canvas one Clio. So call up that and then add it here. So once this is done, so if I take you to the screen and then I'll just write something. And if I shake my device, I cannot show you the shaking of my device, but you can see. Okay, I'll show you with a label that I'm shaking it. I'll go to the designer, just add a label on the top, and then go to the block, and then label text 2. Okay, I should change this because this is a text field, and then it will take it to accelerometer. Okay, I'll just take one parameter, that is y acceleration. So if I go here on the screen stream, and now you can see it is 2 minus 1.507, and then I draw something. And then if I shake it, you can see the shake was, and then it got cleared. I hope everyone got until here. Please let me know in the chat session and be active there so that we have an interactive session. And the question is, yesterday I was okay, attendance of network problem. So yeah, sure, we'll consider it. Please let me know your mail ID, so we'll do it. So can we use different methods like when accelerometer is shake, do canvas empty? Yeah, you can do it for any purposes. Like you can do something like when accelerometer is being shaking, change the text label to something else, or change the background of the UI, or play a music, or change the music. Anything can be done. We'll have that music app tomorrow, or if time permits today. So then we can add up. Like when you change, it goes to the next. So we can do anything. It's all up to your freedom. So last two things you did, I didn't understood. Okay, last one was I did is like once I drew the complete canvas and then it was drawing it. To clear it, I used accelerometer. You can find the accelerometer from the sensor palette on the designer screen. And once you're done there, come back to the blocks, click on the accelerometer sensor, and then call up the shake. Do when it is shaking, and then call canvas clear. That's all. So what happens is when you shake the screen, that is phone, your canvas gets cleared. I hope it is clear. Now, please let me know in the chat session so that I can go ahead, please. Those who all couldn't submit the attendance and had some issues with the various different factors, please reach us out on our mail ID with the same reasons, and we'll consider it there. Reach us out at info.hummingbirdstech, and we'll help you out with your queries. Okay, then we'll go ahead. What does the back symbol on the right mean? Back symbol on the right means, in the sense, consider you have this block, and this block same complete block. Example, this is a very big block you have done. This small actually, but example, you have done a long block, and then you don't want to do that complete thing again. And you know that you will be using the same block in some other application also. So what you do is you click right click and then add it to backpack. That backpack will have that complete block. And then wherever, like whatever the application you create or new project, and then you click on the backpack, you will have that complete block there. For an example, I had added this block yesterday. I've added these blocks yesterday, so it is there in the screen. See, this is such a long block, and I had added this yesterday, so I have it. So this will help you save the time. It's like your clipboard where you have the clips. Sir, is the label necessary? No, the label was just to show you that I'm shaking the phone. Exactly, at Pradeep Singh. Okay, now when you did all these things, you created an app to draw and something all, and if it cannot save it, then there is no mean of creating it. So how can you save that same thing now, so that you have that as an image? So for that, we need to one thing, file to get an access. So for that, go to the designer block. Go to the designer block and then click on the storage. On the storage, on your palette, on the storage section, you have file. Click on the file and drag it and drop it here on the screen. Once you do that, you find the file again in the non-visible component because it's not the thing to see. So you have that non-visible component file on the down. And you have the same thing on the component list also. Then go back to the blocks. Go back to the blocks. Before that, like we need to have one more understanding is when will the image get saved? It cannot be like I'm drawing and it is getting saved. So for that, I need a button. We'll add up a button where I'll just delete this label. It's annoying here on the top. Delete this label and then go to the user interface, add a button below the canvas and then change the name to save. Okay, I'll go to the block again. Now when button one, I'll call the do method, that is when button one clicked. Sorry, here is a button. When button one is clicked, I'll call a file and then choose the save method, that is here, call save file text and file name. So with this, in the text, I'll just give a name. New. And then go to the canvas and call up the method that is save as file name to save the image. So you have save as file name from here, drag it and drop it here. And then call the canvas save. So I think so. I'm clear until here. Now, if I click on the button, it will get saved. Okay, I'll just. So I'm here on my screen, and if I'm just writing something here and then clicking on save. The file storage to documents picture. So let me go back to the documents and picture and see whether I have this image. I'll just go to the documents and picture. Just a minute, I have too many files, so let me go to the folder first. Pictures. Okay, just a minute. Until then, even you can try out. Are you all getting the image into your gallery or storage? Hello, good afternoon. Please let me know in the chat session if you are getting it. I have it here. Sorry, not this. Okay, Shreya Pandan, no, sir. Do one thing, go to the MIT App Inventor permissions and allow the permissions to store. That is, go to the permissions, storage is allowed, and then you should get it. Error is coming, sir. Check out with permissions, that is storage permissions and so on. And also do check out in the MIT App Inventor it shows that is an error, but do go and check out your gallery for the same, and you should have the file, image file there. Okay, Shreya Pandey got it. Okay, with this, we'll go ahead with our other topic. Before we go ahead with other topic, I'll just show you one more thing as an addition to this. You have something called notifier to just give you a confirmation. You have something called notifier, just drag it and drop it here on the screen. And when you drag it and drop it on the screen, that notify is also a non-visible component, so you'll not be finding that in the screen UI. So you have that on the down part, that is notifier. So click on the notifier screen, that is it asks you what is the background color, so let it be default, and then it asks you for a notifier length. So you have options to choose from two, that is short or long. I'll just keep it as it is, not being changed anything. And then click on your blocks. Call up the notifier, and then in the notifier, I'll call up this, that is call show text dialog message with the title. So I'll just drag it and drop it and add it with a button. And here, in a text dialog message, I'll just give a message, go to the built-in function, that is text, and then you have a empty text, drag it and drop it here. I need one more thing, so I'll just copy and paste it, that is Ctrl C plus Ctrl V, and then click here and then give a message. Message will be file saved successfully. And then in the title, message. So if I go to the screen and then allow, here's my screen. And then if I just draw something and then click on save, I get this file saved successfully. And the message is in, okay, here. And then I have a cancel and okay. If I click on okay, no, not from the mouse, from the screen. Yeah. So this is how you can call up the notifier to give you a message. So this can be used in various other things. Consider like you have an application where if you click on something, one button, then it should give you some message so that it is a hint or information to the user, so that can be used there to notify, or something has been happened. So you can call up the notifier and then use it. So I hope I'm clear until here, and we can go ahead with the other topics. Are we done until here, everyone? Okay, as I got the responses S, we'll go ahead with our next topic for today. And that is, we have seen the file component, and in the same file component, we also saw the accelerometer. In addition to accelerometer, we also saw how to use the notifier. So we covered two things for today's agenda, and now we have location sensor. So we'll check out with the location sensor now. So we'll go back and then create a my project. I'll save this project so that I can share you. And did everyone get the .eif files yesterday? I have shared the drive link to everyone on the groups. Okay, good. So I have created a new application, new app, that is app 11, changing the theme first. Okay. Now, our goal is we'll call up the location sensor out of many sensors what we have on the palette, and when we'll have one button and we'll have one label also. So the goal is when you press a button, it should give me the latitude, longitude, and the present address where I am. So this is our goal, and with this, we'll start doing the application. And now we can think of like where can we use this. I'll tell you once we are done making this application. So follow up with me and then we'll end up at the same place. So go to the palette, and in the palette, go to the sensor section. And then in the sensor section, you have location sensor. Drag it and drop it here in the location sensor. And as it is a sensor again, no more on the screen. It should be on the non-visible component list. Then going back to the user interface, I need a button. I'll just drag a button here. I also need a label where I'll get all my address and the latitude and longitude. So I have added the label here. As these are on the left side, I'll just make it to the center, and also this add to the center. Change the text label to empty so that we have the label what we need, and the button text to click here for the address. Click here for location. Done. I'll change the shape to rounded. Okay, this is how my application looks like now. File is not saving, sir. Okay, what you can do is check out the permissions what you have given. That is storage and read write permissions on your mobile phone, and that should help out. Screen is not clear, sir. Okay, attendance link I'll share in a moment. I'm not getting aligned for a label. What you need to do is click on the label and then click on the screen and then set the alignment from here as you have in the screen properties. So click on this and then you'll get the alignment for the screen. So once we are done with this, we'll go to our blocks. Okay, we'll check out that later. Once we are done with that, we'll go to the when button one is clicked, we'll call up the button and then click on the location sensor. We'll click on the label first and then set label. We'll call up the setter method, that is set label, and drag it and drop it here. It's not taking because when button one is clicked, then background color doesn't make sense. So until I change it to text or I have the properties of the color, it will not take it. So once I have done taking it, I'll go to the text, and then I need three things. That is, I need a latitude, longitude, and the address. So I need three things. So instead of taking the empty text, I'll take this joint. So this will help me join multi-texts, multi-parameters. Please tell process of stream mobile screen to computer again. Programming with NI3. It's pretty simple. You just need to have one application, that is screen stream, and then you're ready to go. Just click on the stream there and then use the same IP address. Okay, coming back here. Once you're done with this, now I need to have three things. That is, first one is we have latitude, longitude, and the address. So I'll go to the text now and then take the empty text and drag it and drop it here. I'll not drop it because I need the parameters. So I'll click here and then one more string I need. Okay, I have three strings. Good. Now, once we are done with this, click on a location sensor now. And then go down, you have location sensor current address first. Okay. And then again location sensor, then we'll choose latitude, and then we'll again choose what to be chosen? Altitude. So once we are done adding this, it shows PNG cannot be created. I followed all the steps through. But Mohammad Hirani, please go back and check out your gallery. It should be there or in the document folder. Sir, yesterday I was absent, so I have watched the video evening. All those who has a problem with the attending part, that is attendance, and haven't submitted the attendance form, please reach us out on info.hummingbirdstech@gmail.com and we'll assist you there. I'm sorry if it is streaming or buffering. We'll fix it out. I think so it's playing perfectly here on my screen. Okay. Once done with this, we'll go to the designer, that is our screen, and then check out whether it's working. Hello. So this is my application and it is not I'll click on a reset because it has been disconnected. Yeah, companion, scan the QR code. Attendance link I'll share, please. Just give us some time, we'll share the attendance link to you. Let us finish this and we'll have attendance. Or after this. Okay, I am on my screen. Now, if I click here for location, it should give me a location. It says no address available, and then 0 and 0. That is latitude also 0 and longitude also 0. So now what you need to do is go to the properties. That is first is go and turn on the go and turn on the location first. So go and turn on the location first. And then also make sure that you have given the permission to MIT App Inventor to access the location. It depends on the mobile to mobile, like how can you give the permission to it. For me, if I just click long on the app and I get an app info, you can go to the app info and then click on the permissions and then assign it a permission, that is enable the permission to location. It may take few moment to get the location, so please be with it. Even I'm not getting it now. Let me wait for a second. It says MI2AI companion searching for the GPS. Let us wait for a moment and then until we get it. So we have button one set label one to location sensor, latitude, longitude. Okay. Is it necessary to give storage permission? In app properties, can we add up anything app to still automatically access? Yes, it is very much necessary to give the permission, and that's what the Android does with every updates. That is, it restricts the permissions, so it gives you freedom that which app needs to be given access to the permit files, location, microphone, camera, and so on. So you need to give the permission. Even if you do with Android Studio, you need to first give the permission there. Even if you want to access the internet, you need to give the permission for the internet. Also, please share your mail IDs and all these things into our mail ID so that we can help you and assist you better. So you can see on my screen that I have got my address here. It's not exactly correct, but approximately correct. This is not my home address or my home, that is building name, but it approximately correct. I'm from the Bangalore. So if I just click on it once again, I think it should change a bit. So I hope everybody are getting until here. My screen, sir, screen is not clear. I think so. When I zoom this thing, it doesn't be. Please share PPTs. Yeah, we have considered your request for sharing the material. Tomorrow we'll be sharing the complete material for all the apps we have developed and also other textbook PDF where you can have the complete access, complete information for MIT App Inventor development. Okay, please let me know if everyone got until here. Everyone got the location. And all those who have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do consider subscribing to the channel because that means a lot to us. So we were expecting 500 yesterday, but we couldn't. So please help us getting that thing done. And if you feel this is useful to you, please hit on the like button also and share it with others. Once again, I request all the participants who have not given their attendance for yesterday, please reach us out at info.hummingbirdstech@gmail.com and we'll surely assist you with the same. Please share in Telegram. Can you please mention out like what to say share in a Telegram? If it is about the files and the information, we do share everything on the Telegram also. Not getting address at Pradeep Singh, you will get address in a moment. Make sure that you have turned on the location and also have given the permission for the MIT App Inventor application access to the location. If you have done with this too, please wait for a moment and then you'll get your address as even I wasn't getting address as you saw on the screen. So you'll be getting address in a moment. See now my address is see, different now. I'm sitting on the same. I'm sitting on the same place and it says my address is 161 Second Cross. Okay, I hope everyone got until here. And please be active on the chat session because that's where we get to know about you and your updates. I'm waiting for it. I'm not getting it. PPT notes, etc. Share on Telegram. Surely we'll do it. Tomorrow we'll share all the PPTs, PDFs, and also the link for the quiz. The not quiz. .aif, that is project files. Shall we go ahead? Okay, so going ahead, we have now social messaging, something like this. So before we go to that, I'll tell you where can we use this location sensor and how can this will be helpful. Consider you are creating an application where you need to get the location access, that is your latitude, longitude. You have many various projects where you require this, and the GSM GPS module cost you much. It cost you really much, and then again so much of programming and so many things are there. And then again, you need a Arduino board or other development boards, Raspberry Pi and so on to configure the same. And then finally you get the, and also you need GSM 900 module and so on to send the text messages. After doing all this drama, then you get the location sensor, and that you don't get the exact address. You get the latitude and longitude, and then later you use that latitude and longitude, they get the location. So what you can do is, if you have this application, consider like you have taken a small mobile phone, just a normal one, and then you have made an application. So this will help you to utilize this complete thing, that is the sensors available on the mobile phone completely for your projects. So you can have the accelerometer, you will have sound sensor, you will have camera, you will have location, GPS, messaging, every single thing in one application, and this complete mobile phone will be your kit for the sensors that you need not buy other differently. Tell me how to align the buttons to the center of the screen. No address available. Please do not become sad. You will get your address. Just wait for some time. Okay. How to address is just aligning the buttons are click on the screen and then here go to the align horizontal and align vertical and change them to center and you should have your buttons on the center. And the next question is attendance. Okay. Take a moment, and this is the attendance link for today. And we'll stop taking the responses in by the end of the webinar. And yesterday we got 192 attendance. So 192 people have given the attendance. So here is the attendance link for you. Please go through this and fill up the attendance form. Attendance mail ID share in Telegram for yesterday. Sorry, we couldn't do that because we want to know that you have attended the session, so we cannot share that attendance link on the Telegram. However, we'll surely share feedback and quiz link on the Telegram after the webinar also. Okay, we give you 2 minutes of break and then please go and fill up your attendance sheet and come be back here. And we'll start with our other pro we'll start with our next project, that is social texting and phone calls. Address 00, please check out. Have you given the permission for the location and also for the enable the location access, that is location. And if you done, please wait for a moment, you'll get it. And also, all those who have not yet subscribed, please do. We have 493 as of now. Let us help us reach 500 for today. That is two now. And thank you for all who have subscribed to it and are here. Let us reach 500 subscribers for today. Okay, good that we will have done that. We'll go with our next project, that is how to access the social. Sir, you zoom the screen. I'm not doing anything for now, so I have not yet zoomed it. Sir, kindly tell you info email ID, that is we have shared it in the messages. info dot hummingbird stack at gmail.com. Unable to join the Telegram chat group. Can anyone add me, please? Please help some help him get added, or reach out to me, I'll help you get added. Okay, coming back to this now, as I said, like, okay, now consider like you are in a distress, or like you are in a place where you need to send your location to someone out of nowhere. Like, you know that you are not safe here, and you want to know that, you want to let others know, your friends, your family members, to know that you are here. You want to send them a location, approximate location. So for that, let us make the application. So we'll have the application same, we'll not add anything else to this. What we'll do is we'll go here and then click on the social. I'm teaching you the development of the applications like in a practical way, so that like it's more easier to understand. So we'll not change this, let us have the same, and then we'll click on the social here. And in the social you have texting. Yes, texting. And click on, drag it here, texting. And again, texting is a non-visible component. So you have here, so texting you have in the non-visible component list. And then click on the blocks. And in the blocks, when button one is clicked, you also get the label having the complete address, latitude and long altitude. We also need an address, so click on the set texting and then click call up any of the setter method. I'll just change this to message, set texting message to. I'll duplicate this completely again, Control C and Control V, or you can right click on, click on duplicate, and then click on the texting one, and then set texting phone number to. So if I just click here and then phone number two, so phone number is an integer, so it cannot be a text. So I'll go to the math and then click on this thing and then give a number. So if I give 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, it doesn't exist, but you give your own number. So once you're done making this much, let me take you to my screen. So here I am. So now when I click here for location, it again says no address available, because yeah, that happens because when they give it a chance of, as it's not in a made, it is in a live, that is testing phase, and it does nothing for now, that it is not even text sending a text to anyone. So set texting one message to, why isn't it calling anyone? Okay, we'll do one thing, we'll go to the texting and then okay, we didn't call the send message, call texting one send message, that is important. Without that, no action will be taken place about the texting. So now see, I'll just go back. If I click here on the, click here for location, I'm not getting my location. That is a different scenario, because I should get my location in a moment. I still didn't get my location. Anyways, we'll wait until it is coming. Quiz time. Okay, we'll get you a quiz also. Okay, we'll click on your clicker for location and see. This takes me to message screen, and then whatever the address was there, that is no address available, it was because I didn't get my address yet. So, and then if you just click it, it will go to that this thing. So this is how like you can directly send the message. I mean like you'll have the complete address and you'll get the message directly there. So I'll just remove this until I get it here. I'll go to the screen stream, go back. I'm still not getting my address. Let me wait for it. Now you can ask me like, sir, I don't have time. Like if I'm in a emergency, again, I have to open my phone and all these things should be happening out. So how can I do directly texting? So for that, what you need to do is go to the texting on the blocks. And then you have something called send message direct. If you click on the send message direct, this will directly send message by itself. It will not open the messaging app. Instead, it will directly send the message. But the problem with it is, not every API level, that is Android and Android versions and other, that is manufacturers. For an example, I have a Realme device, so it doesn't allow me to directly send the message. So if I click on the directly send message, it's I got my address again in new address. Anyways, so if I just click here for location, it says send SMS has been denied, please enable it in the settings app. So if you are given the permission, please go and enable in the setting app, and if you enable it, it will help you directly send the message with just a click. Sir, how we copied the blocks, can you repeat? It's pretty simple. Just click on the block. This is the block. Click on the block. This. Okay, I just collapsed it. Click on the block. Control C. It will get copied. Control V. It will get pasted. That's all. Any components to track the live location? Yeah, you can use location sensor also. You have one more method in the location sensor is location changed or status being changed. So whenever there's a change in the location, it'll alert you. So now like I got my address, I think. Yes, you got this. I got my address, so I can. Okay, change to the new tab. No worries. I'll open the screen stream here. Okay, so if I just remove this thing, because that's not, I'm not giving it a permission to directly send the message. Now if I click on the screen, I'll just see, if I just click here, I got that complete address here. And then I can send it directly without any writing my where I am. So this will save much of your time. And this can also be used in projects where you need to have the location address or track your bots or your project where it is and what's happening with that. So you can do directly everything from here. I hope I'm clear until here, everyone. Very good afternoon. Now instead of I'll just tell you one more real case scenario where you can use this. You can add up the accelerometer, and whenever there is a shaking, I mean like example you're walking normally, it will not give you any problems. It will not give you any problems, and so just add up the accelerometer sensor, and whenever it is shaking, it just sends a message to whomsoever you have defined to or whomsoever you have mentioned in the phone number list. So that will help us, like example you are fighting or something happened or you fell down, so there will be a harsh change in the moment. So that will help you to directly send the message that something has happened to you or anything, distress call. So you can use that for old peoples to track what are they doing and if they're safe or they fell down or something such. Example, they're in the wheelchair. So if wheelchair is moving, it will not have any much shaking. And if he falls, it'll have a shaking. And you can sense that from using the accelerometer shaking. And then you can send all these things that the person has fallen down or something like that. Sir, how can we get to know that what method can do, like other methods available for location sensor. Okay, so we'll go to the location sensor, and then you have two things, so others also. For example, you have location changed and then status changed. So in the location change, like if I want to show this location change, I need to move from my place and go to different place so that I have a change in my latitude and longitude. So that will help me to get whenever I'm changing my location. Whenever I'm changing my location, that will give me the latitude and longitude and also the speed at what I'm changing. So I cannot change it from now because if I leave it from here, then I cannot do the webinar. And then you also have one more do method, that is status change, which indicates like whenever there, like you set up some parameters, like this is the thing, and then when that is being changed, so whatever you have asked for it does it. And then you can enable current address distance travel. You have many other setup methods, that is latitude, and you can get all those things. Please do check out all those so that it will help you to understand it better. Make an application and then try out going out, and then see whenever there is a change in the latitude and longitude, and you should get your desired instruction executed, whatever you have applied here. I hope I'm clear until here. Let me go back to the designer screen and then check out. So you also have in the social, you have like contact picker, email picker, phone call, phone number picker, and all other things. So you can use all these things also, like in the phone call picker, what contact picker, you can pick the contacts in the anything for a live video call function. MIT App Inventor as of now doesn't support anything for the live video call function, but yes, we have other methods to do. I'll introduce you to one method. How can you do that thing with the battery management thing? Because MIT App Inventor doesn't even have a battery management also. So I'll introduce you how can you have more functions using the MIT App Inventor. Kindly send feedback and quiz link. We'll do share that. Both the things by the end of the webinar, so that we have a okay. With this, I'll take you to the new thing now, that is which isn't there in the MIT App Inventor. That is, if you check out all the palettes, all the sections of the palette, you'll not find something called a battery. If you go and check out all the sections of the palette, you'll not find something called battery. So for that, what you need to do is now, this is I want everyone to kindly pay attention here. I'll tell you the steps how can you go ahead with this. Before that, I'll just share you my This is the link, drive link, where you will find the files. So what happens is the components or the sensors which are in there in the MIT App Inventor available as of now. There are developers who develop extensions for that. By using those extensions, you can add up that functionality in your application. So for that, what you need to do is you need to go to the experimental here. You have a, sorry, not experimental, you have extensions. And remember, extensions are .eix file, whereas project files are .eia files. So if you have I have shared the link, open the link, and then you will have a 5-6 extensions there. From that extensions, once you open that link, choose the battery extension. I have already downloaded that complete thing that is there in my mobile phone, that is PC. So open that thing and then choose the battery one, that is com.puravidaapps.typhoonbattery.eix. choose that thing and then open it and then import it. Click on import here. If you click on import, in a moment you will find that component here on the extension. So you can see I have Typhoon battery here. I'll just drag it and drop it here. Sir, please tell us what about yesterday's quiz questions. So quiz was active until night 12 and then I turned it off. We turned the responses off because we want it to be very fair with all the participants, because it's meant to be all those who have attended the complete session. So we had to turn off the responses by 12. We had given the deadline as 10:30, but we waited until 12 and we got around 290, which was 100 people's difference than the number of people's attended, give the attendance and number of people who have submitted the quiz. Sir, I cannot open the link info.hummingbirdstack@gmail.com. Why? This is an email ID, so you can use it for sending us the mail. For confirmation, I have sent you on WhatsApp, sir. Thank you. Okay, I'll check out later. Please let me know if everyone got until here, like have you done until getting the Typhoon battery extension imported on your application? Please let me know. I'm waiting for your response. All you need to do is you have this I've shared you the link, that is drive link, just above your chats. Just open that thing, and once you open it, you have 7-8 extensions. From that, you choose the com.puravidaapps.typhoonbattery.eix. Download it. That is just 45 or less than 100 KB file. And then once you have downloaded it, go to the extensions on the palette and then click on import extensions. And then choose the file that is Typhoon battery and then click on import, and then you should have your extensions on your palette. I hope I'm very much clear. If you have any doubts, please let me know in the chat session, and if you have done doing it, please let me know even the same. I'm waiting for your responses. Hello participants, please let me know on the chat session if you are done with this. will surely mail you the Google Drive link, send you the Google Drive link on your chats, that is WhatsApp, Telegram, everywhere. But as of now, as we are doing it right now, and I want you all to do along with me, so I've shared the link in the chat session here. So please let me know if we have got it done, that is, were you able to import the extension into your app? Done, done. Okay, we have done. So once you got your extension on your application and you have dragged and dropped it here, and then you find it in the non-visible components and also in the component list. So we'll do is we'll add up a few labels so that I get the values. Here are the labels. I'll just add up one label and one more label, one more label. Four labels. Okay, I have added. We have to do it every time or one time. At Pradeep Singh, can you please mention out like what should we do every time or one time? Okay, once we have done, I have added five labels, that is four, sorry, four labels, that is 2, 3, 4, and 5. I'll go to the blocks, and then we'll have your Typhoon battery. Click on the Typhoon battery, and then when button one is clicked, I'll remove this complete blocks. I don't need this. I'll not require any of this. I'll delete all these things. I'll remove this also to make it simple and clear. Okay. Now, when button one is clicked, set label. Set label text to. So I need for four labels, so I'll just copy it and paste it. Control V, 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 V. And then paste it, and attach it with this. The import of the extension. You need to do import of the extensions in whichever app you have to do, because that doesn't come pre added in the MIT App Inventor. So you need to import the extension. So once you're done with this, click on the. So I'll change the label one as this is label 3 and this is label 4 and follow it until label 5. And then go to the Typhoon battery, sorry, as Typhoon battery, and then you have many things like, okay, we'll take its health. Then we'll also take level of the battery. And then we'll also take technology of the battery, and we'll also take the temperature, which will help us to know the temperature of the battery. So I have taken four of it. You have many other parameters also to be taken. For example, you have all these things: capacity, energy, health, plug status, and voltage, and so on. So you can choose that from many. And you also have one more method, that is do method when battery is changed, that is when there is a change in the variation in the battery levels. So I'll not take that as of now. That will help us like keep on active, that is if the battery is changing and all these things. But having this as just a click, this will only let you to get at that moment of time. So we'll check out. So I'm here on my screen. And then I have this. If I click here for location, that is okay. We get the, I didn't change the text for this button, so pardon me for that. Same, you see, good, that is battery health is good, and the battery level is 44, and the technology is lithium ion, and the temperature current, that is temperature of the battery, is 37. So this is how we can have the track of the battery, and you can also use this temperature of the battery to measure the temperature, get to know. Now you may ask me, like, what are the other ways, like where can I use this and where can I have the same as an benefit into real application. Consider, like, we cannot charge our phones continuously. We may charge it to 100% every single time or keep it overcharged. It will surely deteriorate the battery. What we can do is have this extension, that is battery up extension. Keep the level that if the battery measured, like keep in a track. If the battery level reaches more than 90, then integrate the Bluetooth connectivity on the same, and then turn off the charger, or turn off so and so, turn off the socket, or give a red light indication, or play alarm tone, anything such. Or if the temperature of the battery is raising, or so you can have alarm or any indication that temperature of the battery is very high, so you need to cool it down, something like that. You can also integrate that Google text to speech. Okay, sir, could you repeat it once? Sir, drive link is not opening. I think so, it was correct because other participants got it. Anyway, I'll share it once again. So here is the drive link, and I'll explain it once again. First thing is we need to import the extension. So extension is just a click here, open the drive link what I have given you, download that com.puravida.typhoonbattery.ax file, and then import it from here. Once you import it here, drag it and drop on the application. Once you have done with that, same, I have just added five labels, that is four labels, sorry, and the button was click here for location. I didn't change the name for it. I'll just change it now. So click. Okay, so, and then going to the blocks, when button one is clicked, I'm calling the do method. When button one is clicked, I'm setting the label text to, if you click a typhoon battery, and then you get all these parameters to be chosen, that is capacity, charger, current average, and so on. So I just dragged and added to the set method, that is setter methods, and the setter things are health, level, technology, and temperature. So I hope I'm clear until here. So when we export our projects to APK, can we add APK icon to that? If yes, can you tell please how? Yes, I'll tell you. That's a very good question. Kindly send the feedback link and quiz link if we want to add the refresh button to update our address. Yeah, you can do that. Like whenever you had one method was when the location is changed, so you can call up that thing and then you can do the same. That will automatically refresh it. You can add up the delay. And how can you change the icon? That is a good question. So if you click on the screen one here, and then just a minute. You have something called icon here. Click on the screen one on the components and then go down and you have a icon here. So click on the icon and then choose a file. If we don't have a file, then click on upload file and then it'll ask you for a file. Give the file and then you'll have that file in the assets here on the media, and then you'll have that file also listed here. You can choose that file and then your application icon will be the same what you have chosen. So here is the feedback link, and this feedback link is just to know how was the today's session and if you have any suggestions and so on. So this is the feedback link. And one more thing to clarify, we'll not be sending you certificate even for today because this is not the last day of our webinar. It's the second day of our webinar. So we'll be sending you certificates tomorrow after tomorrow's feedback again. So this feedback is to get to hear you, wh what you feel about the workshop and what should be improved so that we have a better understanding between. And this is the attend okay quiz link for today. Great guys, we have 498 subscribers for now. So we need two more to reach 500. All those who have not yet subscribed, I request please do subscribe to the channel and let us reach 500 and more for today. That will be very kind of you. You can skip that question, or like you can have any answer for the same, and we'll consider that giving you 1 marks extra for the same. So we have covered the agenda for today, whatever we have to cover. And we are also top of the hour, that is 12:29. So it's almost end of the time. So I thank you everyone for attending today's session. And especially Hummingbird for being supportive on the same. If you have any doubts, please let me know in the chat session. I'll be here and answer your queries. And all those who have been requesting for having this session on students project and so on, please do mention the same into the feedback form, and we'll let you know when can we have the session completely on how to have your projects, that is students projects or any other projects, how can you integrate it with, let it be Raspberry Pi, IoT development boards, Arduino, how can you communicate between the same, how can you have your application linked with the same, and so on. We'll help you out with all the things in the same. So let us know in the feedback if you need that workshop, sorry, webinar. You can also attend the quiz until the whole day end. So you can come back here and utilize this time for asking the questions and so on. So send the quiz link and the feedback form, Hiteshri Lokhande. Thank you for that. You can just three messages above, three chats above, you have the feedback form and the Google form link. Sorry, quiz link. One more subscriber, we need to reach 500. Please, all those who have not yet subscribed, please do consider subscribing to the channel. And that's what helps us to keep on coming with all these webinars. Your support means a lot to us. So please hit the subscribe button and also click on the like so that we have more likes as possible. So you can ask us your doubts or queries if you have any queries considering to the projects or where can we use these applications or you have any ideas and you are not sure like how can you go ahead with the same. You can ask us now. We'll help you clarify your doubts. Thank you all for supporting us. Sir, my score, you can click on the view and then we'll get your score there. Yeah, we are done with the session. So we can leave for the session. And if you have any doubts, you can ask us. We'll be here to answer you for next 5 minutes. So you can ask us your doubts. What can we learn in tomorrow's session? That's a pretty good question. Tomorrow we'll learn how to do the phase detection application. We'll learn how to access to the vibration motors. We'll also learn how to have the music player. And we'll also learn how to create a Bluetooth connectivity and control the Android, Arduino boards or anything such. So we have all these things for tomorrow. And if time permits, I'll take you through the Firebase database and how can you get access to the same. So these are the things for tomorrow. And if you have any new ideas that you want us to cover something, you can let us know on the feedbacks, and then we'll see if we can afford to the same, we'll do the same. Sir, I did not understand anything yesterday because the screen was not clear. We are sorry for the same. Like, if screen wasn't clear, you can go and check out our YouTube channel, and you have the video in 1080p resolution, and you can, that will help you understand the concept very much clear. And if you want to get started from the very basics, you can watch the previous webinar video available on the same channel, and that will let you understand from the very basics, and also how to get access to the camera, or to get access to the various sensors, light sensor, and so on. We also saw how to get access to the media, that is sound and all these things, in the very first webinar. Show to upload app on Play Store. For that you need to have the membership, that is $25 you need to pay, and then you need to have a lifetime membership, and once you have done with the membership, you can upload the same onto the Play Store. And the Play Store account what we are using isn't in this laptop, so we are sorry that we cannot show you, but surely we'll try to get you the screenshots and all these things, how to go step by step if possible by tomorrow, or we'll share you the PDF how to go with the same tomorrow. And also all the methods how to get started, we'll share you all the PDFs tomorrow. Any other questions? We do read all your feedbacks, so feel free to tell everything on the feedback form, and that helps us improve our webinars so that you get what you need. We also got requests to have webinars on Python, data science, AutoSpy softwares. We'll surely let you know when we'll have upcoming webinars. Keep in touch with us in Telegram and so on, and then we'll let you know. Can we get the job based on MIT? That's a probable question. It depends, like if it is a corely, like if it is some small startup who just require their small application to be developed, then you can surely go ahead, and if they're willing to pay. Else, if it is an app development centric, then they'll not let you go with this. So it depends, like what you do, who is hiring you. Android app development webinar day 2 quiz total points 8 per 8. That's fantastic. Great, keep it up. Very low voice. I'm speaking a bit low because we're almost end of the webinar. Okay, we'll end up the session for today. Thank you all. Thank you for being today, and hope to see you tomorrow again. And we'll have a wonderful session. Thank you. Sir, your name? My name is Ahmed.